the scenery, the architecture, football, the accent, comedy. Ugh, the list could go on. Just some of the words used to describe the city of Glasgow. If you're thinking about coming to visit Glasgow, but you're not really sure what it offers or where to start, well, don't you worry, my wee pal, that's where I come in. To show you the people to meet, the things to see, the food to eat, everything that helps you get into the depths of Glasgow.
Well, hi there. My name is Grace Nicol and I am a Scottish radio presenter who was born and raised in Glasgow. Since I have been all over Scotland, but recently I've been brought back to my hometown.
Now, lots of people ask, Glasgow, is it not a little bit cold? And the answer is yes. Yes, it is. On average, I think in the summertime, Glasgow sees about 2.5 days worth of sunshine. But that's when we go down to the parks and we get taps off weather.
You can get about Glasgow on the subway, on the trains, or even the buses and come to some of the most iconic streets like Sauchiehall Street or Buchanan Street.
And when we're not in the midst of taps off weather, why not come down to Scotland's third longest river, the River Clyde?
And also located down by the river is Scotland's media centre, so keep your eyes peeled in case you see a few celebrities.
Now, when you come to Glasgow, there's many excursions to take part in. You might want to go up the Clyde in a banana boat, but really what you want to do is come along to the Armadillo or the Ovo Hydro to see many concerts and festivals. If you're a bit like myself, I'm a huge Eurovision fan, so this place will look extremely iconic to you. And if you're not, well, this is exactly where they filmed the Eurovision film, which was called The Fire Saga Story, and Will Ferrell knocked out a bin just over there.
What the hell, man? I'm in here!
I'm not sorry!
Glasgow's got a busy town centre too, so if you are a shopaholic like myself, then there's no worries here.
Now, there's one thing my mum's taught me. If you want to see some good architecture in Glasgow, all you got to do is look up.
Glasgow really does have some spectacular scenery and amazing architecture, dating right back to Sir Charles Rennie Mackintosh, all the way through to current designs.
Now, if you haven't already fallen on your backside from Glasgow's amazing architecture and looking up all the time, you might have one burning question if you came across a particular gentleman. And that is, what is with the traffic cone?
Well, meet the Duke of Wellington. He led his forces to victory over Napoleon in the Battle of Waterloo. But climbing up and placing a traffic cone on the Duke's head has become a popular hobby among cheeky Glaswegians. That boy is never without a hat.
We then come to the sport of Glasgow, football. There's two different teams. You've got Rangers, who play at Ibrox, and then you have Celtic, who play here at Parkhead. For non-football fans, this means that one team plays in blue and the other plays in green. Both teams are steeped in Scottish football history and have had many players grace the field, from Henrik Larsson through Ali McCoist.
Ali McCoist, given the chance to break the post-war record of league goals, jointly held at the moment with Derek Johnston, who's here at the ground today. He's done it! 3-0!
Let's talk about Glasgow's main attribute, the comedy. Comedians like Billy Connolly and Ricky Fulton paved the way for Scotland's funny bone and proved to the world that the best humour definitely comes from the city of Glasgow. Since we've had comedians like Karen Dunbar, Kevin Bridges, Elaine C. Smith, and some top quality TV shows like Scott Squad, Only an Excuse, Still Game, and we can't forget about the famous Tune the Fat.
The taxi driver, well, what a Glasgow man.
A Glasgow Jimmy.
full of the banter, non-stop, sitting in the back there. I could hardly make a word out, but the ebb and flow of his phrasing was absolutely delightful.
Well, that's your taxi patter for you.
Aye. Well, the general thrust of it was Fitbar, the Rangers and the Celtic.
Ah, the Glasgow Fitbar, eh? The Blues versus the Greens. Tell me, Gary, which was he? A dandy Ranger or a battling Celtic?
Well, James, that I couldn't tell, but he was very, very nice indeed. At one point, he called me his honey.
No.
Oh, I tried to tip him, but he just threw it back and said, keep it hum.
Now, even though Scotland is a country that's native tongue is English, you're going to need some help with the local Glaswegian dialect and accent. So let me teach you a few words and phrases said in the Glasgow way that will help you with your travels when you visit. Scunnered. That just means to be tired or exhausted. Dafty. Or walloper. An idiot or a stupid person. Gingy or ginger. That just means a bottle of juice or soda from the shop. Peace. That is like peace, love and tranquility, but it also means sandwich. Square goal. A good old-fashioned fight. Kind of. Now, personally, I wouldn't encourage to have yourself a wee cheeky square goal, but instead to go out into Glasgow city centre or even the West End to enjoy some of the amazing places that we have to eat. And drink, of course. The tip in Glasgow is if anyone asks you if you want a cheeky double, you just say yes.
Now, if all of that isn't enough to make you fall in love with Glasgow, well, don't forget the real reason why you're here. For the booze.
No, sorry, I mean the people. Aye, the people. Whether you're out geeing at Laldi in the local nightclubs and bars, or just talking to a local for the banter, the people really are what makes Glasgow. So let us know when you're coming to visit. We'll wrap you up nice and warm, sort you out with some food, and of course buy you a pint, because that's what Glasgow's all about.
I'm just outside a club called the Garage. The Garage. I was there just the other night with a couple of lads, and they were saying to me, oh, you're such a walloper, like, this guy's such a walloper, which means, like, party animal. So yeah, really cool street.